God of glory, we gather to celebrate your victory over death and the power of sin. The empty cross and the promise of the resurrection are tangible signs of hope in our broken and sick world. We pray for our brothers and sisters around the world who aren't free to sing their alleluias out loud. We give thanks for those who glorify you this day in places where hope is in short supply, in places recovering from natural disasters, torn apart by war, isolated by disease. We pray for those who suffer in mind, body, and spirit, who lack the strength to sing alleluia. We offer alleluias on their behalf, praying for healing so their voices can join in the joyful songs of praise. We give you thanks for your saints who have gone before us, singing in your heavenly choir, grateful for their lives of faith. Help us to live as Easter people throughout the year. Let our lives be signs of your unending love. We pray in the name of our risen Lord, Jesus Christ. Amen.
Thanks for joining us here at Independence First United Methodist Church on our first online service on Easter Sunday, Resurrection Sunday, when we get to celebrate Jesus Christ and his return from the dead. And so thanks for joining us. It's going to be a little different, a little new, but we're excited to provide this for you guys, and thanks for joining us. We're going to get started with some praise, some worship with Gino and Angie leading us in some music. So feel free to join along at home and just worship the Lord. Thanks.
Loving care, and though my heart grows weary, never will despair. I know that He is leading through all the stormy blast. The day of His appearing will come at last. He lives, Christ Jesus lives today. He walks with me and talks with me along life's narrow way. He lives, salvation to impart. You ask me how I know He lives. He lives within my heart. Rejoice, rejoice, O Christian, lift up your voice and sing eternal hallelujahs to Jesus Christ the King, the hope of all who seek Him, the help of all who find. None other is so loving, so good and kind. He lives, Christ Jesus lives today. He walks with me and talks with me along life's narrow way. He lives, salvation to impart. You ask me how I know He lives. He lives within my heart.
Greetings this Easter morning. I welcome you in the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit as we celebrate Easter in this strange way this morning. Those that attend know that I don't normally wear a pulpit robe, but on this Easter, I always wear it on Easter because of the special, the uniqueness, the holiness of this day. And the robe symbolizes that the covering of God's grace that covers all of us. Also want to welcome you as we come to this time of prayer to check your prayer requests that went out in the weekly newsletter, to draw in these moments names and people that are isolated, alone, afraid, or sick. Please be in prayer for Virgil Bybee as his wife Dolores died this past week. These are our prayer requests. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayers.
Come and fill our hearts with your peace. You alone, O Lord, are holy. Come and fill our hearts with your peace. Alleluia. Come and fill our hearts with your peace. You alone, O Lord, are holy. Come and fill our hearts with your peace. Alleluia.
O holy and risen Savior, we come to you this Easter morning in humility, confessing our sins and our brokenness and our need for you. And we lift up those in our community who are sick and we pray for your healing. For those that are isolated and lonely and fearful, we pray for your resurrected presence to be with them, comforting them, encouraging them, giving them strength. Lord, in this time of virus and sickness and pandemic, Lord, we pray for the scientists and the researchers and the caretakers and the medical personnel as they seek to care for those, what we call the frontline defenders. We pray for your creative spirit to be able to see and know and discover, but also that healing touch for the dying, Lord. We pray that your welcoming arms and eternal spirit would comfort them, they would know your presence and be welcomed. We lift up to you all the prayer requests that we have in our hearts. And we pray that on this Resurrection Sunday that you would give life to your church that has gathered in strange ways this weekend. For this particular church, we ask for your strength and blessings as we seek to find our way forward for the United Methodist Church and all churches. We pray for renewed vigor and health. And help us not to forget the purpose of our ministry in this time of stress and discussion and distraction. May we be alive as you are alive in the world. These are our prayers as we pray the way you taught us to pray. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom and the power and the glory forever. Amen.
This morning's scripture is from the Gospel of Matthew, chapter 28, verses 1 through 10. After the Sabbath, as the first day of the week was dawning, Mary Magdalene and the other Mary went to see the tomb. And suddenly there was a great earthquake, for an angel of the Lord, descending from heaven, came and rolled back the stone and sat on it. His appearance was like lightning, and his clothing white as snow. For fear of him, the guards shook and became like dead men. But the angel said to the women, "Do not be afraid. I know that you are looking for Jesus, who was crucified. He is not here, for he has been raised, as he said. Come, see the place where he lay. Then go quickly and tell his disciples, 'He has been raised from the dead, and indeed he is going ahead of you to Galilee. There you will see him.' This is my message for you." So they left the tomb quickly with fear and great joy and ran to tell his disciples. Suddenly Jesus met them and said, "Greetings." And they came to him, took hold of his feet, and worshiped him. Then Jesus said to them, "Do not be afraid. Go and tell my brothers to go to Galilee. There they will see me." This is the word of God for the people of God.
Thanks be to God. The Lord is risen. The typical response is, "He is risen indeed," and I hope you responded in a similar fashion or something close to that. Christ is risen. He is risen indeed. That greeting goes back almost to the beginnings of the church as we have come together, reaffirming, reawakening in us and in the world this love for God who is alive. That's a historic moment this morning as we come to worship in different places, drawn together by little electrons beaming through the air. The sanctuary is empty. I have never preached in an empty sanctuary. I've never rehearsed a sermon in an empty sanctuary. It's weird. I have never missed an Easter service. As I reflected and thinking about coming up to this time, I have never missed. I went a service. I went to church, literally carried to church the Sunday after I was born. And so I've never missed an Easter service. Even in my wayward times, I was there for Easter. And Easter always makes me a little nervous. It's the importance of the message. It's the extraneous activities that go on. It's the large crowds with names of people I haven't seen since Easter that I can't remember because, I'll be honest, folks, I have to check my driver's license some days just to know who I am. Today, it is harder. It is more emotional. It's sadder that we would gather together and the sanctuary would be empty. The two Marys went to the tomb that morning. I'm sure they were filled with great sadness and grief as they went to anoint Jesus' body. Probably some of the same loneliness and weakness that we have discovered that we have during the season of Lent, as every week the rules have changed and we become more and more isolated, more and more fearful of disease, of death. We have learned that we are fragile. But like this sanctuary, the Marys discovered that the tomb was empty. Angel appeared and says, "Why do you look for Jesus? Why are you looking for him there? He is not here. He is risen. Go tell his disciples." Because that's where Jesus is, with his disciples. The first people that God wanted to know that Christ was risen were his disciples, starting with the two Marys. Jesus is with his disciples. Where two or three are gathered, Jesus is among them. Jesus is with the weak, the lost, the frightened, the sick, the hungry, the poor, those who do not know how they're going to pay the rent, those that do not know how and where they're going to find food. Go quickly now and tell his disciples that he is risen. Lent's gone. There's no need to continue in this mopey, despairing feeling, focused on an empty tomb, focused on an empty sanctuary, focused that our lives have been turned upside down. We've got a story to tell. We are ready for this. I am. Last week, as we talked in the parking lot, I talked about the word that the people were shouting as Jesus rode in. It was Hosanna, which means, "Lord, save us. Save us. Hosanna on the highest. Please, God in high, come and save us." That is so last week. A lot has happened. Jesus was tried, abused, tortured, put to death. And now he is raised from the dead, giving us a new word for this week. We've moved on from Hosanna, "Lord, please save us," to Hallelujah. Hallelujah, which means, "Praise you, Lord. Praise God. You have done great things. You're almighty. You're wonderful." Hallelujah. I invite you to say it where you're at. Hallelujah. Changed things, didn't it? Hallelujah. Things feel a little different. It's amazing how just saying a word can change our reality. But not really. That's God's secret. God spoke, and out of nothing, just his word, he created. And he created you and I in the image of God's very own being, which is creative spirit. And when we form words and ideas and we bring them to reality and we speak them, we begin to create a new reality. Not on the scale of what God can do, but hallelujah, it is something new. Maybe like the two Marys, We should go quickly now and begin to tell this new resurrection story that Jesus is alive. Stop worrying about last week. Start looking to tomorrow, because we are alive and we will be alive forevermore because Jesus has conquered death and is raised from the dead. He is risen. He is risen indeed. Hallelujah. Things have changed. The reality of Easter is a little more tangible. And to be honest, it's a little more tangible every year I celebrate it. The conditions and realities of this present life lose power. They fade and become dim in the light of the risen Christ. We have no reason to fear death. Now, that doesn't mean we do something stupid like run to the beaches and crowd. But death has lost. We will not be forgotten. We live forever in God with Jesus Christ, our brother. God has won. The virus doesn't know, but it's lost. Death is lost. We shall live on. Hallelujah. Kind of a ninny nanny noo noo to death. This is why Easter is the most important day on the Christmas year, on the Christian year. It is not simply a celebration. It's not simply of an event long ago. Easter is about the two most important periods in our life. Today, go quickly now and tell. And tomorrow, living for Jesus. Today and tomorrow. We can't always count on a tomorrow in this reality, but we have a tomorrow for all eternity with Jesus Christ. The tomb is empty. Hallelujah. Christ the Lord is risen. He is risen indeed. It was in March, late March 1993, when a sudden snowstorm, a 100-year snowstorm, hit the Smoky Mountains. And four medical doctors from Knoxville, Tennessee, had chosen that weekend to go on a hunting excursion in the Smokies. Since they didn't expect to be gone long, they didn't tell their family or their staff. They just figured their SUV would carry them out into the backwoods and bring them back when they were ready to come. So they were surprised that when the snow came down and it fell and it fell and it fell until their SUV couldn't budge, they were stuck. They were frightened and bewildered what to do next. And so they suffered through 2 days, and as the evening of the second day was coming, they were in the SUV and someone had found a old stale donut in the back, and they had broken it, and they were sharing it and wondering what to do when they heard a helicopter. And they got out and they began to wave and get attention from the people in the helicopter, and they looked up and the helicopter spotted them, and there in the helicopter were other hikers and other hunters being rescued. And they watched as they dropped a basket down to them which contained a note with one word: tomorrow. Well, the four sophisticated doctors got out, formed a course line, and with all they could do, with all that the snow would let them do, they were doing the course line kick, kicking their legs as high as they could. Can you imagine that? And they broke out into song. Tomorrow, tomorrow, I love you. Tomorrow, you're only a day away. Their fear was gone. Help was coming. They would see that help. We could add that to maybe the songs we sing. He is risen, and tomorrow we live with God. We can live resurrection lives. We can go quickly now and tell others because we know tomorrow God will still love us. Our lives will matter tomorrow. We will always have tomorrow in God. Hallelujah. He is risen. He is risen indeed. Death has been defeated and is in the grave. Let's pray. Eternal loving God, we just come to you this morning, asking you to take away all that sense of death that binds us and holds us. This reality we know that is passing away. And lift up the sunrise and tomorrow and the hope of your healing and the promise of your love and the resurrection that is ours. In the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, I pray. Amen.
Oh,
Christ, laid in death in his grave.
Go and quickly tell everyone that you meet of the love of God the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. And may the resurrected Christ be alive in you, giving you a sense of peace, assurance, and hope. May God touch your broken body, your broken spirit, and give you the light and joy of tomorrow, today. In the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, amen. I invite you to turn and look at somebody. If there's somebody in your presence, if they smile at you, do what we always do, love on them. If you are alone, pick up the phone, call somebody. If they answer, love on them.
Christ laid death in his grave.